scenario they pulled off with the Pacquiao situation. So yeah, I would say and I'm going to tell you why. Canelo's not the best. They keep saying he's the best. See, when Mayweather said he was the best, Lee, we all like agreed with it. You know what I mean? That's the difference between that situation and this one. De La Hoya and them are walking around, "Oh, we're number one in the sport. We're number one in the sport." And they're not. They're not number one ticket sellers in the sport right now. They're not the number one pay-per-view marquee name in the sport right now. His last fight didn't even break 300,000. There's nothing special about that number in pay-per-view at all. So, and I don't even know if Canelo has even broke his Cotto versus Canelo. I believe only hit 9. It didn't even do 1 million. The only time he ever did great was with Floyd, who we know Floyd, you put him in the ring with anybody at this moment and he was doing 1 million buys. So, no, Canelo, there's a big difference between the way El Heyman was able to use Floyd against the leverage he had against Top Rank and Manny, especially when Manny started losing, everything totally went in favor of Floyd Mayweather. In this situation, Saul Alvarez is not in the driver's seat. He just isn't. If anything, these guys are 50-50, him and Triple G, and that's going to be their biggest problem as they try to carry this thing out, is eventually the fans, which I already think is happening, Lee, because his numbers were low. The fans are going to start giving up on Canelo, and especially if De La Hoya doesn't bring a true threat as an opponent, even if they're not going to go with Triple G.
Yeah, I completely agree. And while we're on the topic, we haven't talked about this. For those that don't know, Richard Schaefer used to be associated with Oscar De La Hoya. He helped sort of engineer a great exodus over for a lot of fighters to the PBC. There was a lawsuit. Richard Schaefer disappeared. Is it true? Is Richard Schaefer going back to Golden Boy?
No, there's no way that's happening because they ended in court. I don't see that happening.
There was talk of this.
No.
Like Richard Schaefer is repairing his relationship.
Yeah, I don't see it happening, Lee, because Oscar, all right, look
I'm
it.
just telling you
Listen,
the
I'm going
inside
to
dirt
tell
that I
you.
was told last night that Schaefer.
De La Hoya would be everything that Bob Arum used to say he was. I promise you, if he brings Richard Schaefer back into his loop, the way Richard Schaefer controlled Oscar De La Hoya's career, I'm in total favor in Golden Boy winning that $50 million lawsuit. Lee, you can't build careers of fighters under Oscar's name. Well, trying to put together another promotional company with Al Heyman outside of Golden Boy. That was wrong. And I think anyone that has any kind of knowledge of how he was doing these one fight deals, knowing that the PBC was going to get made, knowing that Al Heyman was going to break off, Floyd was going to break off, why wouldn't you secure these fighters for your guy? Why wouldn't you tell El Heyman, no, you're not going to fight on Floyd's card unless you give Danny Garcia a four-fight deal with Oscar De La Hoya. Unless you give Peter Kulin a four-fight, two-year deal with Oscar De La Hoya. No, he wasn't doing that. And so Oscar, Bob Arum always says, he wasn't the smartest kid in the book. These guys, they don't finish school, especially the ones that go to the Olympics that do this stuff for reals. At least sometimes there's a Y in the road where you got to choose school or the sport, and many of them that believe they're the next star, they got to go with the sport. I see it a lot. I see it in even with kids that aren't on their way to the Olympics. They're done here at the local level with parents that are trying to push their kids in one of these sports, just to give them an edge. So yeah, a lot of the times these guys are not the they don't get the highest grades. Most of them don't even graduate. They don't even finish school. So Oscar would fit that mold. I promise you, if he brings Richard Schaefer, Richard Schaefer is no good. He burnt his bridge with Golden Boy, and Golden Boy needs to keep it that way. What a damn fool. I would love for someone to interview Oscar and say, what could this man have possibly told you that made you go, okay, yeah, he's back on my team? Come on.
I'm just telling you the talk at the table.
They put him in rehab and try to take his business from under him. There was even, remember,
Well,
no,
Oscar
remember they
doesn't
were
help
trying to
him.
have him sell it. That's what they first wanted Oscar De La Hoya, and it was Oscar De La Hoya's company in L.A., the ones that owned the Staples Center, Lee. They're the ones that came at Oscar and said, man, you need to open up your eyes and see what's going on around you. They're the ones that had him fire Richard Schaefer. It was De La Hoya didn't make that decision on his own. And I'm telling you right now, if his bigger friends, his big, because Oscar has many friends in California. He's made a lot of these people hundreds of millions of dollars when this kid was peaking. If he didn't have those bigger heads tell him that these guys were taking his company from under him without him even knowing it, I think Oscar would have sold Golden Boy to Al Haymon and the PBC would have been under the Golden Boy banner. Dead serious about that. They would not have taken Golden Boy out of the loop. That Oscar's picture would have stood there because they would have bought that from him. That's when I heard that Oscar got a heads up from his bigger heads that help him financially. That's when my whole thing came out about the pictures not being fake, people. I'm not saying they were fake, but I'm saying it was a plot. I'm saying that I don't believe Oscar De La Hoya walks around with strippers and boxing gloves. That has always been my biggest question about those first set of pictures. Why did he have boxing gloves on? Unless the guy taking the picture knew that was the only way he can stand up and get Oscar to do a pose is tell him while he's hammered on coke, booze, and everything else that he was taking a boxing photo. So, you know, De La Hoya might have dressed up as that girl because he wanted to, or he might have been dressed and then told to take a boxing photo to make him enter rehab. There was nothing Oscar could do after those pictures came out was to go to rehab, and he was out of the picture. Everything that Golden Boy does from that point on, that's Richard Schaefer. He burnt that bridge. Can't trust him. I could not trust him.
There you go. I'm kind of scanning through. There isn't really anything going on. It is reported by Dan Rainfield as of Sunday the Chocolito is going to vacate the flyweight world title to keep the junior bantamweight title.
Yeah, he has to stay there. I don't see him moving up any further. He looked kind of pudgy at this division, Lee, and I don't even know if he won that fight. So he's going to stay there, and that'll be it for Chocolito. Look at it. I don't see HBO going really too far with this guy. There's no market there anymore. We said the biggest fight of his career, there was 6,000 people there. So
there you go. That's pretty much all the news of the week. Anything you want to add? I've kind of scanned through to see if anything came up to talk about. There really isn't. It's really quiet for the weekend.
Yeah. Yeah, we had a death in the sport. That story's not coming up for some reason. I got cheap internet or something, Lee, but my internet seems to freeze every time I come on Skype, dude.
No, it's Skype eating up your internet feed. Okay. Who was it that died?
Towels. His last name was Towels.
Towels?
Yeah, Scottish boxer Mike Towell died Friday following a televised belt. Yeah, it's just 25
and
years
I'll
old.
Even go a step further. Wait, and I did see something on
25.
This. Ricky Hatton has sort of started a FundMe page.
Yes.
Yeah. I did see this. Wow, it actually looks like I follow boxing again. So Ricky Hatton is doing sort of a starter type page in England for Mike Powell's family.
No, it's Towell.
Towell.
Yeah.
Towell. 1991 to 2016. Yep. Mike Towell.
And what I like about this story is supposedly when the kid went down, he went down in the ring, they canceled the rest of the night. And when do you ever hear that, Lee? You know, I guess you'd say in honor of him, you know, going down the way he did in the ring, the promoters canceled.
In honor of him dying?
Hey, it's better than the show going on.
No, you know what?
The show goes on. Is that what you're going to say?
No, the show doesn't go on. There's a couple of things about boxing I don't like. This, you're right. Somebody gets hurt or there's a death or whatever, that's it.
I thought that was cool of them. Yeah. I thought that was cool of them.
Okay. When somebody wins a fight, could you guys stop please thanking God?
Oh, you already did that.
I've said this a million times. Thank God correctly. I would like to thank God that neither of the fighters in the ring got hurt and that we were able to perform for you guys at the best of our abilities. That's it. That's a great thank you to God. Don't you agree?
Yes.
That sounds right. Yeah. Instead of, yeah, I'd like to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Giving me the strength. Power. Yeah.
He gave me the strength. He what? Your Savior gave you the strength to beat up another man? Oh, terrible. Terrible, yeah, terrible, terrible.
Sad news.
Terrible, 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 terrible. Got to stop that. Anything else you want to add?
Nope, that was it.
That's it. Everybody go enjoy your week. We will be back at the end of next week. We'll have a show for you next Sunday. Usually it's out by noon Pacific, 3 p.m. East Coast time. But it does come out on Sundays, depending on what time football. Next, that weekend, I might be with you, Andrew.
Oh, yeah, I'm at
watch
home.
The Raiders and the Chargers up in the Bay Area.
Yeah.
So we'll probably have to record on Saturday night. So you'll probably get an earlier show next Saturday. To whomever won the Roy Jones Jr. shirts this week, congratulations. As I'm recording this, nobody's won them yet. There's no possible way for anybody to have heard these shows yet, but, you know, you go out on a limb. Sign up. iTunes, iCloud, Spreaker, and iHeartRadio. I personally prefer you guys to sign up on iTunes, but, hey, whatever floats your boat. Or you could just go to, really simply, you could type in fightnetradio.com, and it'll take you to a page where you can listen to the show. Man, that's pretty simple.
Boxing's going to be really boring in October, huh?
Yeah, by and large, October seems to be the off month, and then November we are
getting hot.
And there's a couple of fights they're talking about for December that seem to be interesting as well. But October is a colder month this for sure. So we will be back next week with more news of the week, and we appreciate all of you for listening. Thanks.
Thank you for enduring another episode of FightNet Radio. FightNet Radio is available for download and subscription on iTunes. Or visit FightNet Radio and tell us how offended you are by today's show. Thank you for listening.